What do you need to consider when selecting a behavioral progress monitoring tool?
This is a really interesting question. Behavior assessment, particularly in terms of progress monitoring, is a relatively new technology. We don't have nearly as much understanding of how to monitor progress and behavior as we do on the academic side. Academic progress monitoring has at least three decades of really intensive research understanding the nuances of how to measure progress. On the behavioral side, we've had systematic direct observation for a number of years, but we really haven't had other options that we could pair with systematic direct observation. So when selecting a behavior tool, you're trying to look for essentially two things. Something which has good psychometric properties. It needs to be reliable and valid, and we need to talk about each of those two terms. And also something which is highly feasible. For behavioral interventions and for behavioral progress monitoring, you're going to need an awful lot of outcome data. Behavior changes quite quickly. It can be different in different environments. And so as a result, we need to be collecting, ideally daily, progress monitoring data, and ideally in the particular period of time in which the child is engaging in the problem behavior and the intervention is being conducted. What that means is that if you're going to use something like systematic direct observation, you're going to have an observer there essentially all the time to be able to record the behavior. So that leaves us looking at some other options. SDO is going to be very important for kids who have very intense needs, but we need to look at other more feasible options when measuring other kids. When picking particular tools, there are two things that you need to look at. Number one is reliability. There are a number of behavioral options out there that have been deemed reliable for screening purposes. Screening instruments are looking at identifying target at-risk kids, and ideally they should identify the same kids over X period of time, over 2, 3, 4 weeks. Progress monitoring tools, on the other hand, need to be incredibly sensitive to behavior change. And so if the child's disruptive behavior or academic engagement increases even a small amount, that needs to be picked up by the tool. Tools which have been deemed reliable for progress monitoring use a very different system of reliability than screening measures. So when picking these tools, it's quite important to really make sure that they've been tested for progress monitoring purposes and not for screening purposes. In terms of validity, they need to be measuring a construct that you're interested in and that the intervention is targeted at. If you're looking at disruptive behavior, you need to make sure they're looking at the same type of disruptive behavior that you're interested in. If you're interested in suicidality or internalizing, they need to look at those particular constructs. And so we can't just run out and grab a behavioral measure which doesn't necessarily have the exact definitions which are aligned to the intervention that you're looking at. So. Luckily, the NCII is starting to go through the process of vetting these tools, and we're starting to put tools up on the website which have different target focuses, and particularly which have been deemed reliable for progress monitoring purposes, and that's, I think, where you'd want to go at this stage. Unfortunately, I don't know of any other large-scale resource which is going to be able to provide those specific tools for monitoring kids' behavioral needs. To wrap this up, you want to look at tools which have good psychometric properties, but you also want to really consider feasibility. Understand that you're going to have to collect, in some cases, if you're doing this over a year period, hundreds of data points. And so really consider how you're going to collect that data. It's nice to collect or pick a wonderful tool, but if you can't use the tool and don't actually collect the outcome data, it's not going to be all that effective.